Hello, this is Deacon Larry, and this is Renewed. As we're still early in this new year, this is an opportunity for us to reflect on perhaps some hopes that we have for this year. Hopes oftentimes are the flip side of a challenge. We have challenges that confront the church day to day in the course of our lives in this time, in this time in the life of the church. And today is an opportunity in the new year to look and to say, perhaps there's a brighter side for us as we look ahead. Let me describe those four challenges. I'll just do them quickly in the words. One is secularism. Another is religious oppression. A third is clericalism. A fourth is ignorance. We start with secularism. Secularism, that notion of religion being moved out of the center of our exterior lives, our lives in the politics and in business and in the marketplace, where religion is something that is put to the side and allowed for private practice, but has no place in public view. Recently, the Pew study of the landscape of religion in America identified that 30% of American adults are nuns, self-described nuns, that is, non-affiliated with any particular religion. That would have been an amazing fact 30, 40, 50 years ago, but it's grown remarkably in this last part of the 20th century and this early part of the 21st century. It's an area that I hope that we can address by the manner in which we present ourselves as church, as a place of welcome, as a place of beauty, as a place that acknowledges even those who are nuns, non-affiliated, as those who are seeking perhaps the good life and perhaps God, and may not even know it. An interesting fact, when you dig below the detail of the Pew study on the nuns, is how many have a deeply held religious faith. They do have a faith in God. They don't have a faith in organized religion. And so our challenge is to be a place that is inviting and beautiful to these, our sisters and brothers. The second challenge was religious oppression, and we can pray and hope. Our hope this year is that the world will be a place that's more accepting, not only of Christianity, but of other religions as well. That the world isn't a place where one religion destroys another. Because when we do that, we fracture the ability for people to believe in a good and merciful and just God. Warring between religions yields no good. The third challenge is clericalism. It's the place of power in the church. It's the name that Pope Francis gives to the exercise of power in the church. Now, it's a name that's associated with clericalism, the state of being a priest, a bishop, or a deacon, but it's also an illness that affects lay members of the church as well, who behave in a manner that reflects more authority than servants. So our hope this year can be that all of us who play active roles in the church can exhibit the quality of service and not authority, that we can show God's mercy and love, welcome and care in the manner in which we serve one another, not in lording over one another. The last one is ignorance, and this is the challenge that's certainly within the church, and it is a call for each of us to again know our faith ever more deeply, ever more clearly, to take up the study of our faith. Whether it's in reading the catechism, reading the scriptures, reading spiritual books, reading a text of theology, being members of faith-sharing groups, so that we become more visible and more clearly capable of sharing our faith, of being evangelizers, or as Pope Francis would call us, missionary disciples. Now, if we string all of these things together, if we're able to rid the world of religious oppression, if we're able to turn authority into service, if we're able to take our knowledge and elevate it in a way that we can evangelize, we may be able indeed to address the growth of secularism in our society and embolden the place of the church in our world. If we do this, we and our world will be renewed.
please like, subscribe, or comment below.